प्यारे सत्संग जी, प्यार से कहिए सतगुरु सतनाम सत साहिब जी, सतगुरु सतनाम सत साहिब जी, सतगुरु सतनाम सत साहिब जी। बोल सतगुरु देव महाराज की जय, सतगुरु देव महाराज की जय, सतगुरु देव महाराज की जय। आज के सत्संग के आनंद की जय, आज के सत्संग के आनंद की जय। द रिस्पेक्टेड हंसास ऑफ दिस कॉस्मॉस, Paramahansa of Nijadam and Satprasji of Nijadam, I bow my head before your good self for your benediction, love and grace. So today is 4/11/2020 and I am here before you to deliver something in English, and that is regarding unity and only unity. So the topic of the day that Satprasji is going to elaborate is unity and only unity. So let us move ahead so as to elevate the souls of the cosmos, because everybody is in bondage. Everybody is totally in the field of mind and maya, and nobody is interested in getting himself liberated permanently. Everybody is wishing for heaven, ancestral slope, sun and mahasun, whereas your mind is fully over there with you. You too have desires, wishes and everything in those very places. Those places are mere picnic spots, and after the lapse of your karma, you have to come back on this planet. So you can't be liberated without alive holy name, which possesses the supreme surety of Satprasji itself, and it is being entrusted by him to a pure and real Sadguru of the time, to whom he gives the power to spread the true mission, Sahaja Marga, Satya Marga, Bringa Mata, on this planet, that is in this cosmos. Our start is from sthul body and end is out of the body. Everything starts from the gross body, that is sthul body, away from 10th chakra, that is 7th plex. Our end is in Surat Kamal, Satguru's abode. Surat Kamal is a place where Satprasji, a true real Satguru, take the soul to Amar Lok. When he becomes a true Hansa, that is combination of Suruti and Niruti. When they two join together, then all the baser elements of mind and maya get separated. So when you are with mind and maya, every body on this planet will be in the form of Atma or soul. The moment you are liberated from this baser element, that is mind and maya, you become Hansa. And in the 11th aperture, 8th chakra, you have to get permanently liberated from this cosmos. So you have to be very vigilant. So when somebody gets elevated by this alive holy name, he goes on making tremendous progress. Every day he lets go your past and future, your wishes, desires and thinking, and you start towards the elevation of the soul. So as we start moving, the end starts coming closer and closer. So when we start our life with alive holy name, that is the true supreme consciousness of Satpurush bestowed to the real and true Satguru of the time. So when you start with that, start is the end. If the start is true and real and truthful, the end is too of the same in nature. So close and close, which provides strength and courage, this infuses a new spirit, a new courage in the Suruti soul. That end is not far off. Then your end is not far off. The first step has great importance in one's life. Problems and hurdles or successes, they all are the results of our own action. Whether we are in sad state, whether we are in happy state, whether we are in problem, whether some hurdles have come in our way of progress, or we have succeeded in any undertaking, they all are the results of our own actions. Whatsoever we do, well within our mind and suruti, that is known as karma. The problem of action is that no one else is the giver of peace or happiness. You are not getting peace and happiness from somebody else. Nobody else is providing you all this. You are getting it of your own. You are yourself complete in all respects. You are Hansa, the segment of Supreme Soul. You are not the segment of this Kalnaranjan. Take it for granted. He is a mind, and the unit mind is there with you in Sushmana. He is staying in the Sushmana and watching each and every activity of yours and guiding all the suratis well within you. So you have to be very vigilant that these suratis, action organs, are also functioning and the conscious organs are also functioning. That these 10 pluxes are very, very important to understand. The 10th aperture is very, very important to understand, because Agya Chakra is a place where this soul takes breath. It is very much present in Agya Chakra. As mind is present in Sushmana, just below it, and our Hansa Roop resides in the 10th aperture. He is taking the breath all the times. So our navel base is very, very important. Even a child who is well within the womb of a mother is taking everything from the navel base. He is fully connected with mother. He is not having any heartbeat well within him. He is not taking any guidance or any help from the brain that has not developed yet. And he is without a mind. Take it for granted. He is with a suruti, but nirti is being provided from the breath of mother. So he is complete in suruti, because his suruti and nirti are there. It is united, and he is a pure Hansa well within the body, and his contact is fully established with Satpurush. He is fully in contact with Satpurush well within the body, and he is consoling, tossing, making it to work within the body. So his mother, his father, his guide, his guru, everything is Satpurush himself well within his body. He is free from all the activities of the mind. So you have to take this into consideration. But the moment a child comes on the planet, the first breath that he takes, the entry of mind, takes place well within him in Sushma. So after breath, the first breath that he takes is very important. Now, this cosmos has entered into his body. Then one has to be very vigilant. Mother and father has to be very vigilant, very cautious. At every type, at every step, they should infuse alive holy name in his surti through ear. Whenever mother teaches anything to his kid, his son or daughter, he should infuse this spirit well within, and then you can see a tremendous change on this planet. If mother possesses and father possesses this high, alive holy name, and when he or she was well within his womb and she is worshipping the Supreme Lord Satpurush, that is holy alive name, his surti is fully concentrated, and with that he is fully and she is fully in contact with the child in the womb. So you have to be very cautious that whatsoever we are getting on this planet is because of our own karma. The problems of action is that no one else is the giver of peace or happiness. Nobody gives you. It is your own efforts. It is your own actions which are providing you peace and happiness. So one's own karma, one's own action are responsible to bring either happiness or success or spiritual elevation. Happiness, success, spiritual elevation are fully under your arms, under your control. So it is up to you what you are trying to follow. So spiritual elevation by Parasurti of Satpurush through Satguru. Satguru is very important on this planet. Don't give so much importance to your gurus. They are not going to make you free from the bondage of life and death cycle. You can go to heaven, you can go to ancestors' lore, you can go to Devloks, you can go to Barpur, you can go to Shivlok, you can go to Golok, you can go to Shashastra's lore. So you can move there, but these are only picnic spots. You have to reap the fruit of your karmas over there. The moment that elapses, you have to come back on this planet. All scriptures and teachings advise us to think not only about self, but about others as well. So when we are on this planet, we should not be selfish to a greater extent, to amass everything for your own self and for your own family. That is not the life. You have to take care of others. Since we live connected lives, we are well connected in bonds with the society, and what happens to one affects all others. in varying ways. Whatsoever we are doing, whatsoever we are acting, it has a direct impact on others. It is direct impact in that very village in which you are living. It has direct impact in the city in which you are living. Direct impact in the country you are living, and direct impact with the whole world and with the whole cosmos, including flora and fauna and all animals, insects, everything is included into it. Your one action, somebody says, if we move a finger, the whole universe moves. Your movement of a finger makes the whole world to move. So, a single sinner sinks the boat, and a single holy person makes the boat to swim. So it is all up to you where you stand. Your one action is taken into consideration by this cosmos and even Supreme Soul, Satpurusha of Fourth Look. Every action of ours is being watched. So all scriptures and teachings advise us to think not only about self, but others as well. Since we live connected lives, and what happens to one affects all others in varying ways. So that's why I am explaining you each and everything. Every brick in the construction of a house, every brick in the construction of a house is very important. It is as important as the house itself is. So, brick by brick, we construct a house. So, if we are filling the belly of our own and we are not worried about the belly of our neighbor who is in any condition, you have to be watchful. If he is sound, okay. If he is suffering in any way, you must come forward to help in all the ways. Ignoring your own benefits, your own comforts, you must take care of the neighbor. And similarly, this process moves ahead and it reaches up to the cosmos. So every action, there is equal and opposite reaction. Your action will teach others to act accordingly. So they too will follow suit. They too will move in the same direction as you are moving. So your one step is a step of your success. It is very close to the end. The moment you have started moving, the end is coming closer and closer day by day. But when you are moving away, you are moving away from. So if you are having true sabad, true word of Satpurusha with you, that leads you towards truth, love, joy and peace. So one step is very important. That one step towards faith is everything. That faith will go on developing in you, and in the same way, truth, love, joy and peace will go on developing along with it. They are in unison. They can't be separated from each other. They are units of the same segment. They are Surti itself, and that elevated Surti is a segment of Satpurusha, our super soul, our father. So the moment you will move towards truth, the moment you will attain faith, trust in your true and real Satguru, you are moving towards the real path. Otherwise, there is no other way to reach to your own father. It is through real and true Satguru. Who can take you towards that very path? So always be ready for that. So have scriptures. Don't take them only up to reading. Make your life accordingly. Move accordingly. Attain accordingly. So then success is very close to you. It will fall on your feet. So success doesn't lie anywhere else. It lies in your own efforts. So whatsoever you are doing on this planet is outcome of your own karmas, your own deeds, your own actions. They are all responsible for all this. Collective welfare is also significant, as it includes individual welfare, and this way there is a binding across the world. Your single action will bind the whole universe. Your single movement of the finger will bind the whole universe. Never think that all the things of the universe are disturbed by the movement of your finger. Let it be a very, 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 very small, but effect is there. So your every good action or bad action will have a direct impact on the society. So you have to take care of all these things. So collective responsibility is there. It starts from the individual and goes up to the extreme limit, goes up to infinite limit. Start at the very outset and then see what is happening. So there is a binding across the world, leading to less conflict. While moving in this very way, there will be no conflict. If you are ready to solve the problem of each other, what sort of conflict will be there? What sort of differences will be there? So it is all up to you. Less conflict and more opportunities for peace and harmony. There will be peace and harmony as well as sustainable lifestyles. Everybody will be in peace of that very unit. And unit to unit, go on spreading this message. Please, have a love with each other. Have a unity with each other. If there is any differences between two, between four, between eight, they should be resolved amicably in a peaceful way. So that will make, that will sustain lifestyles, and it will become a lifestyle of a person in the universe at large. It starts from the very small town, village, and it spreads to the whole cosmos. In the present situation, people try to establish link of entire universe. People are trying. Even small children are working a lot for the welfare of the society, and they are moving from country to country to spread the message of unity in diversity. Establish link of entire universe. As manifestation of Brahma. Because this whole cosmos is a manifestation of Brahma. So from one segment you can reach up to Brahma. You can attain the stage of Brahma himself. You have to go on moving on the path of truth, love, joy, and peace. And the zero point is Brahma itself. First reach there, attain that stage, and then move ahead. It is not the end of all this. You have to move somewhere else. Your final limit is Amarlok, fourth lok. That is not the cosmos only, your limit. Your limit is behind that, up to fourth lok. These fourth lok represent Shuddha Brahma, Nirankar, God itself. But he doesn't represent Supreme Soul. He represents mind and mind only. When any avatar, any guruva, any Satguru talks of mind, he is talking of this God. But when somebody is talking of Surti, he is talking of Satprash, of Amarlok, that's fourth lok. And people are quite ignorant about that. Because Vedas don't mention anything regarding fourth lok, regarding Satprash. So that is a dilemma on this planet. That is the main problem that people don't understand the real purpose of coming on this planet. So, the presence of mind and maya in every life is the same. Because without mind we can't speak, we can't converse. So, speaking and conversing is the act of mind. But the energy is being provided by Surti. We can't raise our hands, we can't speak out, we can't listen without Surti concentration. So Surti is playing a prominent part. You yourself is playing a prominent part in the body. It is you who are functioning well within the body. Your function is very, very important. And pay attention to what you are on this planet. You are very important segment. Realize your importance. You are not insignificant. You are more powerful than this God itself. But you are not realizing your importance. That is the tragedy. So, attain calmness, attain peace, have love, have unity in diversity. There are so many castes, creeds and religions. Don't pay attention to one religion, please. That is a sin. And this sin cannot be forgotten by anybody. You can't be liberated when you think of one caste, creed and religion and you ignore the uplift of all others. You ignore others and pay attention to only one. This is not the life. This is rather, I should say, you are not befooling one, you are befooling the whole universe on this planet. Don't befool anybody. Everybody is wise enough to realize the importance of his own self. In the field of economic outcome at present, norms of cooperative actions are the need of the time. Even if we have to develop our economy, we have to do it jointly. It is not a work of simply a government. Every individual should come forward because it is the need of the time to simultaneously do this at large scale. Solve the problems, worries, shocks that individuals, countries face in a situation like the current COVID-19 pandemic. So this is the time when unity is needed. When these calamities come, they send a signal to establish cooperation, friendship, good relations, communication. In all respects, there must be cohesion and adhesion. Come to the rescue. Definitely, during this very period, rich people have helped the needy. To what extent they could, they came forward to help the needy. And one should do like this. And with this process, we can raise our economy. We can solve the problem of the economy during this COVID-19 pandemic. So unity in diversity is very important. Your cooperation in all respect is very important. Rather than disconnecting from global supply chains, the rich nations need to cooperate and help undeveloped countries. Just like individual to society, society to country, and country to universe. The rich countries too should come forward to help the poor and needy countries who are not fully developed, who are not in a position to fight this COVID-19 pandemic. So they should come to the rescue. This is a noble task, and it should be performed jointly, and the fight should be a joint fight of the whole cosmos for this COVID-19 pandemic. Rather than disconnecting from global supply chains, the rich nations need to help the poor by adopting, helping, and cooperating. All the methods should be adopted in which help, cooperation, standards at individual level, group level, society level, state level, country levels, and at large, world level to mitigate problems. So, from individual to individual, we have reached to the whole cosmos. The whole universe must join together during this period of calamity. The rich should come to the rescue of the poor, and poor should be thankful to the rich for the gratitude, for the help they have shown to the needy and depressed souls. So this is what we have to do on this planet, because everybody is immortal on this planet. Soul is immortal, only this body will join to their parent bodies, to the parent segments. It is a combination of 5 elements. It will depart and join its own parent segments. So someone is needed for the spiritual level also. So Gurus and Sadhguru, they have to come forward to attain unity in diversity. They should come forward to give the message to the society that oneness should be attained. Rather, we should forget what we are physically. We should take it for granted that we are souls. And soul is the same in every creature. Same soul is residing in every segment of this universe. Who is taking breath is having a soul, having a mind. So soul is very, very important. So mind too is important, because we are conversing these 52 words which come in written form, which come in spoken form, which are meant for communication, and all this is an outcome of mind. And Shruti is there to provide strength and energy for its spreading forward. So both are working in collaboration, and the need of the hour is that both must join together to elevate the soul. They must not think of one, they should think of the two. So one must realize his limitations and make a space to accommodate other viewpoints. One should listen a thing properly. When you listen a thing properly, that means you are doing a noble job on this planet. then you are visualizing what is good and what is bad. Don't make an assumption at the very outset that this is good and this is bad. No. Try to stand isolated as a decision maker, as to make a decision what is wrong and what is good. Don't involve yourself into it. Try to keep yourself in isolation as a referee to decide about the two situations that arise before you. You must be a watcher. You shouldn't participate into that. If anybody participates, that shows partialism. You are inclined to one thought and you are not inclined to the other. You must visualize sometimes a very good thing that appears to you that can provide you a great harm in your life. And anything which you say that this is bad, that will provide you a sufficient lesson to be careful in future. So we must act as a referee for every thought that comes to us. We should not behave otherwise. Otherwise we will be put in great harm in our life. So we are responsible for our own actions on this planet. We have to be careful. So one must realize the limitations and make a space to accommodate others' viewpoints. Listen carefully, understand, give them time to your thoughts, and then give a decision to uplift the masses, countries, and world at large. So everyone has to contribute from unit level to the universal level. So this is the time when one should come forward for his own duty to perform. One shouldn't remain in the limited domain of personal and family life only. That's not life. Because in generally, if you see, nobody is related to you in any way. He has come to your house through his own karmas. You are a member of this family of your own karma. Everybody has to get according to his karmas. Nobody will get less and nobody will get more. And whatsoever will you do, it will be added in your life, present life and the future life. If you are going to be liberated permanently, then you are doing a noble task on this planet. If you are in touch with true and real Satguru, you are performing the true task on this planet for what and for which you have come on this planet. The reason for suffering is we all are suffering because of ignorance. Our suffering is because we are not aware of our own selves and we are not aware of others. When we are not aware of our own self, who can we be aware of others? We are interconnected. The moment we will realize our own self, we will realize the importance of others. And without that, no progress can be made in this world. Even at individual level, you have to be very careful that when there is a progress for the whole world, your own progresses too will be taken into account. Every brick has its own role in its own construction. So you have to construct the whole world. And Ved Vyas says, Yogeshwar, he was a Yogeshwar. Ved Vyas ji is a Yogeshwar. He is in heaven, in the first heaven. Go on listening till you understand what he says. Go on listening till you understand. That is why I am giving so many sermons to you every day. Please go on listening, a day will come when you will understand me for what he has come, why he has come, what he is giving, and what is his objective. So whatsoever is my objective is the same of yours. If I am giving this all of Satpurush to the masses, you too should do the same. Your duty is not something else. Your duty is too of the same as of mine. I am working day and night without any benefit for my own body. I am working for the benefit of the whole cosmos. I am working for the benefit of four lokas. Even all Paramahansas are listening to me even at this very moment. All Devi Devatas are listening to me at this very moment. All Rishi Muni, Japi, Tapi, Sannyasi, Yogi, whosoever is there in the heaven, in ancestral's lok, in Sun lok, is listening to me. None is sitting idle. Everybody is paying attention to what this Venam is going to say to the masses on this earth. So understand and have capability to act or react for the welfare of others. You have to understand, then act, react, and do something for the masses. That's what this Venam is doing. Simply go on listening will not solve any purpose. Listening, understanding, reflecting, and then acting will do something, will solve the problems, will tell for what you have come on this planet. That will give you strength, knowledge, and everything. We have a gross body, and deep within it is a subtle body. This sthul body is known as gross body. If you are up to that very level, that means you have done nothing on this planet. Nothing. And you will not be in a position to go to heaven or ancestral slope. Then you have to simply change your body from one to next. You will not be sent anywhere, but simply you will be transformed from one five element to other, say one element, two element, three elements. You will at once you will be transferred from that to that. So this one line is a complete knowledge for the whole masses. Vedavyas said this and I added the rest. And have capability to act, react for the welfare of the masses is added by this Venam. He simply said, go on listening till you understand. So I have given so many sermons on this planet. You are simply listening but not understanding. Understanding includes everything. It includes capability to understand, think, react, and act. That is understanding. We have a gross body and deep within is the subtle body. Sthul and Suksham. Sthul is a gross body and Suksham is a subtle body. And within that is Surti consciousness. And it includes two. I'll take them later on. I'll tell you stage by stage now. Previously, I have given you everything No, I am giving you stage-wise, one and two at a time, and then I will proceed to the next. So, you are passing your life in a gross body, and deep within a subtle body is totally ignored. And our Surti, which is consciousness, awareness, is totally disorganized energy. You are not aware of, but it is working. Still it is working. See what you are within. You are in deep slumber. You are not in a vacant state. You are in deep slumber. You are blind. You are deaf and dumb. You are not understanding anything because you are blind. When you will get this light from true and real Sadhguru, then you will feel the importance of your own self on this planet. Till then, you are totally ignorant. You are fully at a loss what to understand, what to do, what to act, and what to react. So everything is gone from you. So disorganized energy of mind in the gross form has gross body, that is sthul body. So don't be in a sthul body. Move ahead. You are a combination of six bodies. Understand your importance. Realize your importance, what you are. When anger, hatred, or jealousy exist, they generate disorganized energy. That is what I say. When you don't have alive holy name and you are not making the use of it, even if you have and you are not making use of it, that means you are full of anger. And sometimes you become angry with me. For what? I am not doing anything good or bad for anybody. I am doing good and bad for the whole society, for the whole universe, for the whole cosmos, including fourth log as well. I am talking for all of you and even for Paramahansa who are in Amar log, who are fully awakened, who are fully aware of, but they watch me. To what extent I am giving the masses, where so ever I am lacking, they will generally come to my rescue. They do come in my rescue. They are teaching me every day, at every moment, in every segment, and I am obliged to them. Perfection doesn't come. It comes when you open your mouth. So Amrit will fall in your mouth when you will open your inner mouth, not outer mouth. You must have thrust within. For having something, you will get it. This mouth is an artificial one. It is mere a show purpose. Artificial flower. This body is an artificial flower. Don't pay much attention towards it. So when anger, hatred, jealousy exist, they generate disorganized energy. They making the soul to act in other way. This is not the quality of the soul to have anger, hatred, jealousy, prejudice. So anger, desire, lust, greed. Anger, desire, lust and greed, they are posing problem to you. They spoil your whole life career. Even my disciples who are not following the path of truth, they will spoil their life career. And they will never be liberated from this cosmos till the bone of Nirankar is completed. You are not mistaking or doing blunder for this life. You are doing blunder for your whole life carriers on this planet, life to lives on this carrier. Be vigilant, be careful. Don't attain these qualities of anger, desire, lust and greed. Don't be always impatient. Don't undergo sex process all the time. Save your energy. It will help you to elevate your soul. I am not in favor of this lust. I am totally against this lust. If you want to move ahead in spiritualism, you have to forsake this lust. So degenerate disorganized energy, that is anger, desire, lust and greed. Yeah, they generate disorganized energy. It makes one helpless. Then a person becomes nuisance in the society, becomes a problem on the society. And the parents, those who do not follow this, their children do follow suit. If you are true religious person, your words, your children too will be elevated to some extent. But when you are simply an artificial flower, not true and real in any way, artificial remains forever for so many years, but real spends a limited period, but that is being remembered. That gives something to the masses, and then your children too will move ahead to have something. Give them to listen, to understand. But there should be with you something that you will give to your children. And without listening to me, how can you give this something to your children? So, miserable and take you in the past and future. What mind takes? These four, anger, desire, lust and jealousy, generate disorganized energy. It makes one, are you, helpless, miserable, and take you in the past and future. What else it will take? It will take to you to yesterday and tomorrow, which is not our objective. That my Sadhguru has not done this and not done this. He knows his job. Sadhguru knows his job, when he has to do anything and when not. Your teaching won't serve any purpose for him. He knows his job. If he is a Sadhguru, he knows his job. And if he is not a Sadhguru, he won't know his job. That is mere what I have to say to you. So those persons, they believe that matter and three gunas may be different across space. But supreme mind or cosmic mind in contact with the matter is the same. That is, mind and this cosmos is one and the same thing. There is no difference between the mind and the cosmos. Whatsoever mind possesses, this cosmos possesses the same. Mind is also a combination of five elements. So same is the case with this cosmos. Cosmos is also a combination of five. So where comes Surti? Surti is not the unit of this cosmos.